of the house. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَأُولُوا الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ. The one, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, has a lot of favors and bounties over a lot of the Sahaba. One of them, Bilal radiallahu anhu, and Mustah radiallahu anhu. And you say, مِنْكُمْ وَسَّعَ. This means Allah Azza wa Jalla give him money. Say Allah, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he used to be a tajir, he's a businessman. He makes money. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Say, and you to the one, as Allah give you money, and you give al-fuqara. You give the poor and the needy. And the immigrants and muhajireen, fi sabilillah, for the sake of Allah, you give this. You give this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when Abu Bakr al-Siddiq heard about this, he stopped to give him and said, no, you have. And then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, وَلْيَعْفُ Allahu Akbar. وَلْيَصْفَحُ You forgive. You forgive this kind of people. And the set, flip the page. يَصْفَح From tasaffah, tasaffah, they begin to read the book, and you take the book one page and second page and say, you have a new page now. Forgive and forget. Forgive and forget the past. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla, he asks a question, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Don't you love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq heard that ayah and he said, I forgive him. I will forgive him and I will give him the money again and even extra. Allahu Akbar. I will give the money back to Mustah, the one he spoke about his daughter, slandering his daughter, and I will give him more, even extra. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Say, Wallahu ghafoor rahim. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive everyone? And he's a merciful one. What we're supposed to do? Imitating that kind of maghfir al-rahma, forgiving each other. That's why I said, anything in your heart against anybody, your brother, your sister, your family, anybody, forgive. What are we going to take from this life? Only our good deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Don't you love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you? If you forgive that person. By the way, you have right not to forgive. You have right not to forgive. But if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive, you're not an angel. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, forgive the others. And that is our role model, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala anhu arda. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ الْغَافِلَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ لُعِنُوا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ So those people, they are slandering al-muhsanat, the woman with chastity, honor and dignity. غَافِلَات, they didn't know. Aisha, she didn't know the people for the whole month slandering her. غافلات المؤمنات the believers in Allah سبحانه لعنوا listen carefully to this لعنوا في الدنيا والآخرة Allah cursed them in the dunya and cursed them in the akhirah سبحان الله Allah cursed what is لعنة we said last time لعنة the one ملعون or cursed he will be out of the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى on the day of judgment He will be out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. May Allah protect us from that. And we are not going to enter the Jannah without the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please give attention to this. We are not going to enter the Jannah without the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that, even you, Ya Rasulullah, قال حتى أنا, even me, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So we have to put this in mind. We have to put this in mind. See, we entering the Jannah, not only our deed is a wasila, is a tool. Our deed, our a'mal, our action, our salah, our zakah, our hajj, everything we do good, that is a tool to take us to the Jannah, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Is a tool to take us to the Jannah. But we are entering the Jannah with the mercy of Allah. With the mercy of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ الْغَافِلَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ لُعِنُوا في الدنيا they will be cursed in the dunya they are not going to have this kind of peace the value of life in the dunya and cursed in the akhir and the hereafter may Allah protect us from that ولهم عذاب عظيم they have a great torture in jahannam والعياذ بالله those people slandering the people slandering the others and now the internet wide open to everyone the internet Wide open to everyone, the internet. If you can write any article about anybody and the people believe it. And some Muslims actually have problems with the government because of this kind of articles. Some people start to write an articles and they call themselves patriots and they start to write about against some other Muslims, and then those Muslims in trouble because of those kind of articles. Slandering, accusing people, slandering, lying about other people. That was lying, slandering, accusing. Those is what, iyadu billah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish those people. This life is short. Let them do whatever they want, as far as you are seeking the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our goal and our target, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and listen to this ayah that's coming up. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. In that day, their tongue, their hands, and their legs, they will be witness against them what they used to do with the tongue speaking, with the hand writing, with the legs walking and going to do the evil things, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And in the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last man will get out of the hellfire, قَالَ يَا رَبَّ أَخْرِجْنِي مِنْهَا. Get me out of the hellfire, the hadith in Muslim. Take me out of the fire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell him, if I tell you, if I get you out, you will admit your sin to me? And say, yes, and he give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises and covenants. He will admit and speak, and will get out, and he look on right side, left side, he found no one there, and then he said, I don't do anything wrong. Subhanallah, you just give all this covenant and promises, and now you say nothing wrong? La ilaha illallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yatba ala fi, sealed his mouth. Sealed his mouth. Then the body parts start to speak. The hands. The hands. The tongue. The ears, the eyes, the legs, the skin, جلودهم, جلودهم, even the skin will start to speak. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. Say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم. This tongue. Remember last time in the, when I was explaining, said the tongue, hadith Mu'adh ibn Jabal. I said, Ya Rasulullah, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold us accountable what we're saying in our tongue, even jokes. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Mu'adh, so Mu'adh, what put the people in their faces or their noses in hellfire, what they committed by their tongues. What they committed by their tongue, saying by their tongue, even if that is a joke, by the way. Even if that is a joke, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الرجل, the man among you will say the word, make one word. لا يلقي لها بال, he didn't know how to say it. Another hadith, لِيُضْحِكَ بِهَا النَّاسِ, to make the people laugh. That word will put the person, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, in hellfire. But one word make the person Muslim, believer, and one word make the person disbeliever, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. One word, yes, that is one. Even if that's a joke, even if that is a joke. There is no joke with that, especially you speaking about the honor of the people, the dignity of the people, the names of the people. We have to protect. If you want the people to speak about you, speak about the others. You don't want the people to, for sure, to speak bad about you. So you cannot speak about the others. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَلْسِنَاتَهُمْ, their tongues, وَأَيْدِيهِمْ, writing article, typing article, things, writing anything about the other people, having different email and emailing the other people and just think advice or something. Those hands will be witness with you or against you in the day of judgment. And their legs, Allah said, وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ, وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ, and their legs, بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, what they committed, what they have done in life, they will witness. May Allah protect us from that. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَئِذٍ, on that day, يَوْمَئِذٍ, يُوَفِّيهُمُ اللَّهُ دِينَهُمُ الْحَقَّ وَيَعْلَمُونَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينُ. Allah, ayah number 25, Allah says, يَوْمَئِذٍ يُوَفِّيهُمُ اللَّهُ دِينَهُمُ الْحَقَّ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold everybody accountable. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold everybody accountable. Remember I mentioned last time also, there is two angels here, writing everything, what you have done. مَا يَنْتُقْ مِنْ قَوْلِ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Any statement, anything you say, any action, those two angels writing everything you do in life. أنا الله سبحانه وتعالى أكان عليكم رقيبا. الله is the best witness. The day is a witness. The night is a witness. The place you are sitting here is a witness. The day is a witness. The night is a witness. The time is a witness. With you or against you. The heaven, the sky is a witness. You're living under the sky is a witness. The ground where you are sitting here is a witness. Everything witnesses. Your skin, your eyes, your legs, everything. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that day, those will be mustantaqat, will be speak up. يوفيهم الله دينهم الحق. This means what they committed with their lives. ويعلمون أن الله هو الحق. Allah is the truth. Allah is the best witness over all this. الحق المبين. Clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the records. And when you look at the record, قالوا ما لهذا الكتاب؟ ما لهذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. What kind of book is this? Never left anything, is everything's recorded. Everything recorded. Yes, it is everything recorded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then ayahs coming up. الخبيثات للخبيثين والخبيثون للخبيثات والطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات أولئك مبرؤون مما يقولون لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking now here. About those الخبيثات للخبيثين, the evil woman والعياذ بالله, evil woman, they always look at the evil man to run after him, or the opposite. Evil man goes under after the evil woman والعياذ بالله. خبيث, what is خبيث? خبيث, the one he choosing the word, switching the word, lying. All kind of evil things the person could do, that's khubith. Khubith, that means you're not saying that would happen from nifaq. That means you're showing something and the reality is something else. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, say, الخبيثون, الخبيثات, the people, the women plotting evil things, goes plotting with the men plotting evil things. But some people, they explain it wrongly. He said, the evil woman marry an evil man. This is not true. It's not true. Because Nuh alayhi salam, look at his wife. Lut alayhi salam, look at his wife. And the opposite. Asya alayhi salam, look at her, who's her husband. Asya alayhi salam. So not, we're talking about the people plotting with women with men. Plotting together, they are khabithin. And the opposite, men with women, they're khabithin wal'iyadu billah. But the good people also plotting with the good people. Plot, not plotting, they are planning with the good people. The good woman, she always want to marry a good man. And the opposite, good man, he want to marry a good woman. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we marry the woman, the men, we marry the woman for many things. Because her beauty, or her wealth, or her family. And then, but in the end he said, or her deen, favor بذات الدين تربت يداك. The one with the deen, with the religion, with the good deen, good religion, marry that woman. You'll be a winner in the dunya and the akhirah. That's what the man supposed to look. And the woman also supposed to look with the righteous man. Not because he's rich, he's this or he's that, or he's handsome. No, or the opposite. Also men should not marry a woman because she's beautiful or this and that. No, we marry the woman because she of her deen. Because of her deen. Because if she have a deen, she will protect the honor of the man and raising his kids in the right way. Raising his kids in the right way as well. See? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us what to do in this kind of situation. Yeah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and subhanallah, say, لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. They have a forgiveness and risk. Because some people, they are running after the money. Some people running after the money. Subhanallah. The money will go. And the beauty will go. And the kinship or the ranks will go away sooner or later. Who will remain? The good deeds of the person. And you need someone to help you in life. A man or the woman. To help you to what? To reach your goal. And that goal is the Jannah. The Jannah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Speak about more details. Remember what I told about this surah? The family surah. The surah for the family surah. Listen to this ayah number 27. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling us for the believers. O you who believe. La tadkhulu biyutan ghayra biyutikum. حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها ذلكم